I hear the growth. When all my friends would say to me, God, you've changed, and in a positive way, and I couldn't see it, I see it with this album and I hear it, and more so today than I did after completing the album. I hear the growth, which I'm really happy about, I'm very proud of. I write about what's in my life and what moves me in hopes that it will move someone else in a positive way. I think I'm independent, but I think it's very important to hear what others have to say and listen, and then, you know, make your own decision from there. More so than anything, I think it's thought-provoking, and it makes the listener think about what's going on in their life, and possibly, hopefully, it will make them want to, you know, make a few changes within their life for the better. Together Again does please me that it has been received as well as it has. I mean, Renee called it from day one. He knew it was going to be a number one song all over the country, and it's done the same in Europe. I mean, it's been incredibly successful, and they're still playing it. Well, normally they'd be on to the next single by now, but they won't let go of it, and I'm thankful that they're enjoying it so much. I've been very fortunate so far in releasing singles that have the public has really embraced, really. Some of them do just pop out at you, like Together Again or I Get Lonely, and then from there you gotta go with what you feel in your heart would be best, really. With the past two tours, and the only two that I've done, it's always been the States first. And this time I made a conscious decision to start in Europe. I love Europe. I'm not necessarily trying to top what I've done in the past. I'm just trying to do what I've always done and what I enjoy, and that's performing and trying to give the best show that I possibly can and trying to make it different than the last show. But we'll definitely do some really fun, neat things with the tour. And I mean, it is kind of difficult, like you said, with all the set design and the lighting cues and everything being programmed to computers and things like that. But there are certain parts that you can plan within a show that you say, okay, this part I totally want to keep loose. And in planning that, you can have that. I had a journalist say to me that he felt that this album was very angry. I think there's one angry song on there, and that's the song What About, and rightfully so, talking about domestic violence. Sitting back and listening to it and thinking of the people that have already come to me and said how this song in particular has really helped them a great deal and how they could relate to it. Women. Gotten that from a lot of women.
That's so nuts.
There would definitely be songs that I didn't do on the last tour that I'm going to do for this tour. Control, Pleasure Principle, Lately Nasty, Velvet Rope, You. To be able to give them as much as you possibly can, even if it's just a little bit, so that they get a taste of it and enjoy, you know, remembering what was going on in their life at that moment when that song was out. And so hopefully they'll enjoy the show. I hope they do. That's one of the truly fun parts is creating the show and putting together the set list and you know the order the songs are going to go in and what am I going to do differently than I did last time and change it up and switch things around. It's the endurance, the stamina, and that grows with each and every day. We rehearse 7 hours a day for 6 days a week with just the dancing alone. So that builds. So with each song that you finish choreographing and you run it, then you have the next song that you finish, you run that, and you run the two together. Before you know it, you have the whole show, so you're running the whole show back and forth. I am very excited about coming to the U.S. It's been a good while. I think it's been 93, 94 I was here. So it's been 4 years since I was in the States performing. So I'm excited about coming home to perform. Listening to The Velvet Rope, the songs that we are doing from the album live, it sounds pretty good to me, and hopefully it'll sound good to the audience. The part that I'm really looking forward to, that I really enjoy, is meeting the kids. I meet kids sometimes before the show, sometimes after the show, and that's the part that I really enjoy as well. Listening to what they have to say, what parts of the show they like, what they, you know, what their dislike may be, or something that they thought they wished I would have done. Just sitting and talking with them about anything, about things going on in their lives and their experiences. It's that energy that gets us up and going on those days where you're really tired and you feel like you can use a pillow, and at that moment, not quite in the mood to dance, but the minute you hear the kids and their energy and excitement and love, it totally puts you in a different space and you're ready to give everything that you have.
My lips hurt.
The dancers and myself will, whether it's go out to a club or all get together and play games, or we'll even rent out a bowling alley and have it to ourselves and just have a party with the crew, the band, the dancers, myself, and just bowl all night. So we'll do fun things like that and plan a lot of our days off to make it worthwhile. There's a possibility as we go along, there may be additional dates, but you'll hear about it if there are. I'm really hard to please when it comes to myself. So it's always something that I could have done better or differently, another way that I could have done it that maybe could have been more effective. It's just the way I've always been. Maybe that's something I learned from my family growing up in this business. Years to come, how do I see myself? Still making music, acting a lot more. Those are the things that I really want to get into, helping others with their music, whether it's through writing, producing, things of that nature.